Don't forget to click that subscribe button to become a member of the Bit Squad. For the month of December, we're giving away a Nano Ledger S sponsored by Nimic. Make sure you guys like and comment on all of our videos in December to get the maximum number of entries. Hello, Bit Squad. Welcome back to the channel. I hope you guys enjoyed that intro. I haven't made it yet, so I hope it was good. No pressure, no pressure, no pressure, no pressure, no pressure. All right, guys, so today we're going to be talking about my experience using a Bitcoin ATM. Now, the specific ATM I used is from Bitcoin Depot, and I'm going to talk about why it wasn't a great experience. I can't speak for all Bitcoin ATMs, but since this is my only one, I got to think probably some things about this are the direction that ATMs are going when it comes to Bitcoin. We're also going to be talking about Bakkt possibly getting delayed. We're also going to be talking about a controversy surrounding the Brave browser. But before we talk about any of that, we need to do our contest. So today we're giving away 40 Ontology coins. So let me pick our winner here. We've run out of challenges, so all you got to do is put your address. So let's see who the winner is. Oh, Alan. Oh, sorry, you did not have your address there. But I appreciate that. Looking good, Dad. I don't even remember what that was about, but I'm sure it was great. Okay, Gandhi. Oh, Gandhi, if you just would have put that address. I did check out his DAP. Pretty interesting stuff. He's a big Bit Squad member. Both of those guys are. Slayer Fan. Okay, so Slayer Fan, you are the winner of our contest. I will send this over to you shortly, probably tonight or tomorrow morning. So for today's contest, we're giving away, coincidentally, 150 basic attention tokens, which, as you know, works with the Brave browser. All you got to do, drop your ERC-20 or basic attention token address down below, and you will be entered to win. Drop a comment while you're at it. I like to see a comment, not just an address. It looks spammy. And also, if you guys didn't know this, if you guys are applying, I make it sound like it's a job interview. Oh, hello, sir. I'm here to apply for the free Ethereum giveaway. I've got a lot of experience in making comments with addresses in them. But if you're entering a lot of these contests on YouTube where you're having to put in an address, like an Ethereum address, then you need to make sure you do a comment along with it, because a lot of times YouTube's spam filters will pick up just the address. So go ahead and make a comment, because I like to see them, but also because you have a better chance of getting past the spam filter. Okay, guys, so a quick look at CoinMarketCap just to give reference to what's going on in the markets right now. The market cap is $133 billion, so up considerably from about the last week. And Bitcoin right now is coming in at 4,029. It has gone back up over 4,000. And a lot of these charts are looking really good. If we look at some of these that are up, we've got Odum, DEX. None of those really count. Let's find one that counts. Wave still continuing to charge. Waves went up a lot. It had a correction, and now it is on the way back up again with a 15% gain. Steam, Holochain, Ethereum, all up over 10%. So it's been a pretty good day on the markets. Don't know exactly what the future is going to look like, but right now I'm feeling pretty good about it. But of course, anytime the price goes up, I feel good. So I don't really know if that means anything. So, okay, guys, let's look at this. Bitcoin Depot. So recently I sparked up a conversation with someone, I can't even remember who, it was someone out in public, and that person told me, oh, you didn't know they have a Bitcoin ATM off Windy Hill Road, which is really close to the Atlanta Braves Stadium in Marietta, Georgia. And so I decided today I was going to go visit it. So my family and I, we went to the zoo, had a fun little day at Zoo Atlanta, and then traveled back and stopped by this Bitcoin ATM. I was totally shocked where it was. It was actually in kind of just a sketchy gas station. It has a hand car wash out front, and I'm going to try to find the Google map image and put it behind me. But the coolest thing about this experience to me was the fact that there was a sign on the window when you pulled up to the gas station that said Bitcoin sold here. I thought that was just phenomenal. I'm so glad I got that picture. It was really cool seeing that. It just reminded me of what is to come in the future. And so I go inside and I'm going to spend less than $100. I actually randomly happen to have like $95 in cash or whatever it was. And so I said, okay, I'm going to go put some stuff in there, put some dollars in there and see what I can get. And just really to have the experience. And so I go in and I go up to the ATM, and the first thing I noticed as I'm going through the process, as I hit the start button, is it says, we are out of Bitcoin. All we have is, well, it didn't say all we have, but it said, currently we have available Litecoin and Ethereum. So I said to myself, okay, I'm going to buy a couple Litecoins or buy a few Litecoins, you know. Litecoins around that the time of the day I was there were around $31. So I was like, okay, I can get like almost 3 Litecoins. And so I start going through the process, and I'm going through the process. It tells me I have to do phone verification. So I have my phone with me, of course, who doesn't? And then they send me a text message, and then I put the code in. So I get past that part. Then it asks me for my name. And as you guys see here, to be funny, I put Bogged is my name, B-O-G-G-E-D. I thought that was pretty funny. And so I did that. And then the next thing was a little shocking. It asked me to verify my identity. And I thought to myself, well, since I put in the wrong name, I wonder if this is going to affect it. And then I thought to myself, holy crap, isn't this supposed to be part of the advantage of using a Bitcoin ATM? Is there's no KYC? Because there are people out there that don't want KYC for negative reasons, because they want to hide money, because whatever it might be. And then you also have people that just, they don't like the government in their lives. And so I thought this was one of the advantages of using a Bitcoin ATM. However, I had to scan my ID. There were only two options. You could scan it with the barcode, or you could insert it. Those are the only options for it. So I went ahead and put my ID in, and then it came up with the prices. And so the price, and I'm not sure if there was a fee baked in, but it said there was an additional $3 charge. I'm going to tell you guys, the price of Litecoin at the time of my transaction was $31. So I put in $90. I should have got almost 3 Litecoins. Once the fees that was baked in, and then the fee was added at the end, there was a $3 fee added at the end, and the price per Litecoin was $36. So I don't know if that bakes the fee in, or if somehow they just use like a higher price. So basically for $90, which keep in mind, I should have got almost 3 Litecoins for, I got 2.36 Litecoins. And you may be saying to yourself, BitBoy, why are you so dumb? Why would you have done this if you were going to lose $10? Well, I just wanted to do it for the experience. I was willing to pay, you know, 10 or 15 bucks just for the experience to say that I've used a Bitcoin ATM, because I thought it was pretty cool. I'm glad I got to do it. However, my ultimate experience with it is there's no reason to use it. If the KYC advantage is gone and the fees are higher than even Coinbase, then why in the world would you want to go use one of these? So the two options, once you make your purchase to receive it, you can either scan the QR code of your wallet, which is what I did for a Litecoin wallet that I have. I used the QR code, got sent right to me. Or the other option was to get it emailed to you. Now, I wish, looking back, honestly, I would have done the email option, simply for the fact that if I would have done that, I would have seen what that actually looked like. I don't know if it just sends you like a paper wallet or whatever, but those were the two options. So overall, my experience was fun. I'm glad I did it. However, I would not ever do it again unless there was an advantage, whether it be not having KYC or if there were lower fees. Now, it's important to note that even though I had to scan my ID, I don't know what the company is going to do with it. I don't know if they pass that information on, but just the fact that you have to share that with someone means that if there was some kind of investigation, I'm sure they would have to give that information over to the authorities. So I don't know, guys. Let me know, what has been your experience with Bitcoin ATMs? If you've used them and you've had a good experience or a different experience or a worse experience, make sure you drop that comment down below. I would love to hear from you. Okay, guys, let's talk about BACT. So if you're watching the futures markets, the CME and the CBOE futures markets that launched last year are settled in US dollars. BACT is going to have Bitcoin futures that are settled in Bitcoin, which gives people incentive to actually own Bitcoin as those are settled. So it could possibly be a very good thing for the market, because it's encouraging institutional money to come into the space. Well, supposedly, when all of this first came out, the news was it would be in November. Then we got an official date from the CEO, and that date was December 12th. Well, recently there was a postponement, and meaning it will come out January 24th. Well, now we've got word there could possibly be another delay. And the reason for this, it's simply just a math problem when it comes to dates. So yesterday was the 21st, and supposedly the application was finalized and turned in. At that point, there's 30 days for comments to be made on this proposal. Now, here comes the issue. Because Monday and Tuesday are Christmas Eve and Christmas Day, meaning they're holidays, that means that the final approval, even though it was turned in yesterday, won't actually be able to be given until the earliest, the 26th. So then at that point, you have to assume it may take a few more days before it's launched. So really, even though this is a delay, they're talking about possibly being a 1 week delay. So if that's the case, this is going to turn out not to be a very big deal. But this is definitely something to keep our eyes on, because BACT cannot launch until this is approved. And once it's approved, there is 30 days before it can launch. So you guys make sure you guys are paying attention to those dates. Okay, guys. There is a controversy surrounding Basic Attention Token and Brave Browser right now. And my personal opinion on this is it's really petty. It's kind of like the mob mentality when somebody says something is bad and some people are like, oh, it's bad. When in reality, it's not a huge deal. We've actually already been seeing something like this take place on Twitter for a long time, and nobody's ever said anything about it. So popular British YouTuber Tom Scott, I have no idea who he is, and I wish even more now I didn't know who he was, but he is very proud of not taking donations and not crowdfunding his social media platforms. Well, that's great for him. However, most of us who are in this this profession of being a YouTuber, like, hey guys, guess what? We don't do this for our health. We do this because, number one, it's something we're passionate about, and number two, there has to be some kind of financial gain from it, or else we would be working at McDonald's. No offense if you actually work at McDonald's. But basically, the Brave browser does not necessarily have a verification system for adding people to its platform. So Tom Scott has a channel that's automatically been pulled into the Brave browser network. And so there are people that have been tipping him through basic attention tokens through the Brave browser. And now he's come out and says he doesn't want them. And Brave browser came out and said, well, sorry, there's nothing we can do about it. It's totally anonymous. There's no one we can would even know how to refund just because of the way the Brave browser works. Now, if you've been on Twitter for a while, you've no doubt seen the XRP tip bot or the Go Seed It tip bot. Now, the way that these work is you basically have in your wallet an amount of XRP or an amount of a Tron token with Go Seed It, and you can say at Go Seed It tip X number of a certain token. Now, if you want to tip someone XRP, basically what it does is it goes and it sits in a wallet, okay? It sits in that wallet, and until the person goes into their account with the XRP tip bot and actually receives those, actually goes through the process to receive those coins, those XRP coins, or with Go Seed It, the Tron tokens, they just sit in the wallet. The person has to go in and claim them. And we've been seeing this for a long time, and no one has said anything about it that this is a bad thing. I mean, you may not like XRP, but the XRP tip bot, in my opinion, is totally fine. This would be like if someone tipped you and you said, no, I don't want that. And it's also important to note that when people were sending tips to Tom Scott, it did say that this was not a verified website or a verified content creator on their platform, and there's a chance that he would never receive it. So the people that were doing this already knew. So I don't see what the big deal is. Now, I do think that this is going to cause Brave Browser to take a step back and say, okay, how can we prevent this in the future from whiny babies like Tom Scott getting upset? I don't know who this guy is. I've never even heard of him before. But honestly, the fact that he's attacking cryptocurrency and attacking Brave Browser and Basic Attention Token without really understanding the full depth of what's going on here, it's pretty upsetting. Meow. Meow. So what do you guys think? Do you guys think this is a controversy? Drop me a comment below and let me know. I know this isn't going to waver my support for Brave Browser or Basic Attention Token. So hope you guys enjoyed this video. I hope you guys enjoyed the intro, because I have no idea what it was. BitBoy out.